beautiful day in the neighborhood. A beautiful day in D-Town. Would you be mine?
Won't you be?
Oh, it is won't you be? Won't you be? Won't you be my neighbor? Or won't you come and cook with me? What up, guys? Welcome back to the Fit Man Cook Kitchen. This is quarantine social distance cooking. Hey, Jesse.
Hey.
What's going on, man?
Oh, you know, just dancing to no music.
Just dancing to no music because you got music in your heart.
And they'll put music in the video.
Guys, I'm super excited because today we're making a recipe based off of one that I made for our Fit Man Cooking Espanol channel. Hold on.
Uh-oh.
Jeez. Yeah, don't put any of this in there. We are making surullitos de maíz, fritores de maíz, or corn patties. This is a really easy recipe, and I came up with it because we were Googling what are the top foods that people have right now but don't know how to use, and corn is one of those things. So today, I'm gonna show you how to turn that corn into something special. It's like Jack and the Beanstalk. Wait, that's not about corn, though. Wasn't that corn part of the story?
I don't know.
Okay, it's probably not. Anyway, let's get to it. Whoa! What up, guys? All right, so the first thing we are going to do is you're gonna need a blender or a high-powered food processor. So you're gonna get this, and we're gonna add in these ingredients. Again, this is quarantine cooking, things that are really easy to find, and today's star is some corn. I've got some frozen corn here. It's been already thawed out, so I'm gonna add in some fresh corn. Hey, Jesse.
What's up?
What does corn say whenever it's embarrassed?
I don't know, man.
Take a guess. I'm proud of this one today.
Something about a cob, corn on the cob, I don't know, popcorn, I don't know what.
Oh, shucks.
Ah, dang it!
Yeah! Kid. Ooh. I stumped him. Next, toss in some garlic cloves, some eggs, we're gonna keep this gluten-free. I'm gonna be using some almond flour, but you can use whatever type of flour you prefer. And then a little bit of personality. We got some cumin, some smoked paprika, and some baking powder. Add in a pinch of sea salt and some pepper. Let's post-blend this on up. Perfect. This is good, sticky texture that we want, just like this. Beautiful. And add our mix to a bowl. Now we're gonna add in a little bit more of our corn and make sure it's already been thawed out, and some green onion. A little bit more black pepper, and fold all the ingredients together. And I just think it's a good practice that after everything is folded together, that you place this in the fridge for about 20 minutes just to get really nice and firm. And after a few minutes in the fridge, we got our chilled batter. Do you know, I forgot something to add. This is an optional ingredient, but I think it actually helps out. You wanna add some cheese?
Yeah.
I mean, you know I want some cheese. We're gonna add a little bit of Mexican blend cheese to our batter. Let's give this a good stir. And if yours is a little bit more loose than mine, no worries, it should still hold up. Just don't make them too big. So we're gonna fire up a nonstick skillet here on medium high, maybe a little high-ish heat. Add in some avocado oil. It's great for frying. Gonna add in more so than usual because we're going to quote unquote fry these. Swish it around, about a nice, maybe about 2 or 3 tablespoons worth. Add it right there to the skillet. Make sure that heat's still high. And you don't want these to be too big. I have learned the hard way.
But not today, right?
Not today. This has never happened. Oh, fudge. That was bad too. This has never happened. I know how to do stuff, Jesse. I know what I'm doing. And give these some room to breathe in the skillet. Don't crowd it. Don't rush. You know what? You would think that I would know all the lyrics now to that song. Don't rush. And we are gonna cook these for about 4 to 6 minutes on each side. So once they get nice and brown and the edges around them started to get nice and crispy, and they can move around freely in the skillet like this, that's when you know they're ready to flip. Our frituras de maíz, our surullitos. Don't be alarmed if they're really fragile when they're piping hot. Let them cool down just a little bit. These are still hot, but you see now, but they have firmed up quite a bit. See that? Now it's firm. Beautiful, nice and crispy on the outside too. Hey, you know what? I have got just one avocado left and the rest of this onion and garlic. Why don't we make an avocado crema? Just really quick, just to drizzle on top. You wanna do it?
Yes.
All right, let's do that. This is a quick impromptu recipe. We're gonna use up the rest of our ingredients. So I've got the bulb of that onion here. I've got some garlic cloves, just two of those. Where's my avocado? I'm not even sure if this is even good. Okay, we're good. We're good to go. It's super ripe. And then I've got some, you can see this is wilted cilantro. We're gonna put that with the stem in there. The stem is actually where you get a lot of that flavor. Let's get some sea salt and some pepper. Hey, Wilson, is there a lime in there? Kevin goes deep, just toss me one. Squeeze in, boom. And then some almond milk. I keep this one plant-based because it'll preserve the life of it in the fridge. If you use regular milk, then oof, and cream, then you've got to eat this a little bit faster. A dash of cumin, just a little dash of cumin. Pop the top, let's go to work. Let's see, yeah. And it's looking super thick. Ooh, I smell it. I'm gonna pour it into your condiment container. Oh my God, I can just go through this stuff, bro. Let's get some salt, flake bay action going. Woo! Be disrespectful with this avocado crema. Mm-hmm. Okay.
What you doing, Kevin?
I'm waiting for you to finish taking these photos. Oh my God, this looks so beautiful. I didn't even want to mess it up. Oh. But I will. Take them for the team. And here we go. Oh my God. It's all right. I mean, it's edible.
It's okay.
I'm only going to eat it because it's here in front of me. Man. Ooh. Let me show the camera. If you don't want to have one, that's fine.
Oh, okay.
You want to try one?
I see how it is. Of course I do.
Go ahead. Oh, you got a big bite, bro.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that wonderful?
Woo! Dude. Dude, these are like candy. I don't even know.
Oh my God. And we didn't deep fry them. It's delightful.
What's that over there?
What?
What's that?
Huh? What'd you say? What? What? I wouldn't blame you, man. I love this. All right, guys, that is it for today's recipe. I hope that y'all really enjoy it. I want you to take that frozen corn or that can of corn from your pantry and go and make this recipe. Again, you can use whatever type of flour you prefer. I use almond flour so I can keep everything gluten-free. No, I don't have a gluten allergy. I'm just intrigued by eating some more gluten-free stuff. But you use what you have and make it do what it do. These fritters are fine by themselves. They're great with the salad, but if you wanna just step up the notch, this avocado crema, man, that kinda just brought everything together for me. Mm-hmm. Like, I really love that, and it's a simple, easy blender recipe. Comment below how you would customize this, but also keep it calorie conscious. And if you're new to the channel, welcome, hello. Don't forget to subscribe and remember to ring that bell, ding, 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 so that you can be notified every time we post hot new content here in the Fit Me and Cook Kitchen. All right, y'all, be safe, stay home, and as always, keep it healthy, but of course, never, ever boring. Boom! Bye, peeps.